What about the States? You forgot about the United States of America? Why did you put so the stop to your career? Un DrakeBell sin escándalos no es DrakeBell. ¿Estamos de acuerdo?
Yeah, exactly.
This is the real tough questions to
ask. I
know.
Super gruñón.
Why did you say yes to the mascara? And everybody says, Drake, hermano, ya eres mexicano. The documentary that we saw another face of Hollywood and music, but you're still here.
I mean, if I could do a song with Peso Pluma, that'd be awesome.
Oye, tranquilo, viejo.
Oye, tranquilo, viejo.
Como dijera ese filósofo, ¿no?
Sí.
¿Recuerdas ese filósofo?
Ah, ya. Yeah.
Ustedes la pidieron desde que subimos el primer video. Súbelo otra vez, dile al Drake que venga otra vez. ¡Él es DrakeBell! De nueva cuenta, el volante con el escorpión dorado. How much time since the last time?
Years.
Yes, like five or six
years.
I
yeah,
know,
really. Yeah.
We saw each other in my late night.
Yep.
In 2020. That's 4 years ago.
Wow.
5 years ago, almost.
Wow.
That's how long.
Wow. Feels like yesterday.
What have you done in all this time?
Well, I've been making records. I've been touring. I just played a bunch of shows here in Mexico, in Irapuato y Tabasco. Got more But yeah, I released some new songs. I kind of relate. Hollywoodn't. I have a new song called Te Desenamoraste. So yeah, just doing a bunch of stuff. I did La Máscara.
La Máscara.
In Mexico.
Sí.
So yeah, just been working.
Claro. Y un par de escándalos también, ¿no? Ahí por el... Porque un DrakeBell sin escándalos no es DrakeBell. ¿Estamos
yeah,
de acuerdo?
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah, okay.
Do you get like addiction of this roller coaster, this twister that you live
no.
in your life?
No. I
no?
don't.
Come on.
No, I don't.
You're a junkie.
Yeah. No, man. It just seems to follow me wherever I go. I don't know why.
Yeah, the only way that nothing happens, it's do nothing.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, like you don't walk outside.
Exactly. But you are, do a lot of things, so you are always in the edge of
yep,
something.
Yep, seems to be.
How can you describe your own life in that way?
You know, my life is simple. The media makes it out to be some crazy thing, but I'm very simple. I hang out at home, I go to the studio, I record, I eat food, I drink water.
¿Cómo estás ahorita en el amor? En exclusiva, DrakeBell duda de aceptar su noviazgo con Alex Stretchy.
No, love is a dangerous thing, my friend.
You have a girlfriend now?
I don't.
Yeah, this is the real tough questions to ask.
I
can talk to you about.
People already know all the everything about my life. Let me keep something to myself. Let me have one thing
yes.
to myself, please.
Well, I'm asking you because I can get you a girlfriend here. Like, ¿tienen novio ustedes? ¿Quieren un novio? ¿Qué les parecería ser novios de DrakeBell? ¿Tú tienes novia? Digo, ¿tienes novio? ¿Tú tienes novio?
Sí.
Ah, ¿Tú no tienes novio? Ah, bueno, tenemos dos candidatos. Ella tiene novio, los demás no.
Okay.
¿Qué les dirías para conquistar el corazón de DrakeBell? No, eso no funciona, eso no funciona.
¿Y los billetes?
¿Y los billetes? ¿Cuáles billetes?
¿Y los billetes?
Ahora sí, díganme, ¿qué le dirían para conquistar a Drake?
Te canta la del gruñón de George.
Ay, no recuerdo esta canción.
¿Cómo es? ¿Cómo es?
El gruñón de Josh es súper gruñón. Es súper gruñón.
Y ahora rompe cosas. Ya ven al reparador de lápices.
El gruñón de Josh.
Tarararán.
Es todo un gruñón.
Tarararán.
Súper gruñón.
Your Mexican fans are the best, right?
Yeah, the best. The best.
They love you a lot.
Yeah.
In yeah. all the concerts, they are there. They are singing your songs and
yeah,
jelly.
Yeah, it's incredible.
Crazy. What do you think about Mexico? It's now your country because a lot of people love what you do in the past and in the present.
Yeah, I mean, that's something that's amazing about Mexico is they just, they love everything that, all the new stuff, all the new songs, all the, it's, I've really gotten to grow with them and they've grown with me and they're just an incredible, incredible audience.
And everybody says, Drake, hermano, ya eres mexicano. So you're living in Mexico full time now or no?
Well, I'm here in Mexico right now. I've been recording my record for the last forever, and it's coming out in October, and so I've been here doing a lot of recording and working. So I've been spending a lot of my time here.
Yeah,
I just got back from Florida. Was out there for a little while. I'm going to LA here pretty soon. And so we're just tying up all the loose ends on the record so we can get it all finished.
What kind of songs are we going to hear? Because you make like this special style for each record.
Yeah,
right?
Each record has a different style, but I think this record kind of puts all of those styles into one record. There's some rockabilly songs, there's pop songs, there's pop rock, there's pop punk, a lot of different, there's some, a lot of Latin. Uh-huh. Influences, bossa nova. I mean, there's tons of.
¿Ustedes son fans de Drake Bell o no? A ver, cuéntame, cántame una canción de Drake. Pues en español, pendejo, dímelas. ¿No te las sabes? So it's a mix of all your story.
Yeah, yeah, it's like all the styles of each album. Each album has been different, but this one I kind of put everything together, so it's very eclectic. It's got a lot of different genres.
Are you gonna make some tour in here in Mexico?
Yeah, we'll be touring. I've got like 10 shows coming up. I'm doing, you know, Mexico City, Monterrey, Guadalajara, Cancun, San Luis Potosi, a bunch of different places. And after that, once the record comes out, then we'll do like an official, the album's called Nonstop Flight. Uh-huh. And so we'll do a specific tour for the album.
That's cool. And what about the States? You forgot about the United States of America?
I know, I did. I left them a long time ago. No, I actually have, that's why I'm going back to LA. I have 3 sold out shows in California.
Wow, that's cool.
And then some shows in Florida.
What do you think about the United States? I hear you like something in your heart, in your mind. I don't know. What's your relationship with your own country?
It's a love-hate relationship. I mean, I don't know. I'm just kind of over the U.S. right now. Everything's kind of, you know, L.A. has gotten really bad, and the crime and the
homeless.
The prices are so. I mean, everything is just crazy, and it's just not as cool as it was 10 years ago. You know, and. Yeah, I'm not really, I don't know. I come out here and I just feel at home. I feel way more comfortable and peaceful and...
Even with this fucking traffic?
Oh, well, I'm used to it. The traffic doesn't bother me because coming from LA, I'm used to this. So
yeah.
Everyone always says like, how do you deal with the traffic in Mexico City?
Yeah,
I'm like, I'm from LA, so...
And what about the food?
Because I mean, I go back to the States and I'm like, everything tastes like bland chicken soup. Yeah. I'm like, where is the flavor? Where is the spice? Where is the, I'm always like grabbing hot sauce. I'm trying to add to everything. Everything tastes so bland. Yeah, I can't, Mexico has destroyed food in the US for me.
Which is your favorite?
My favorite food?
Yes, favorite Mexican food.
Favorite, you know, Mexican food?
Yeah, like tacos or enchiladas or...
I mean, chilaquiles, tacos al pastor, gringas.
A mí me encantan las gringas también.
Yeah, but it's hard too, because here in Mexico, I mean, everything is better than the US. I mean, whether you're eating Japanese food, sushi, Chinese food,
Greek food. Because it's all Mexican style.
Greek food, I mean, everything that you eat out here is better than anywhere else. So it's not just specifically Mexican food, you know, you guys are great at everything.
The thing that with you and your music, we watch you, that you love music.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm wondering about your Hollywood, your acting career. Why did you put so the stop to your career? Why did you don't follow and try to make some more things in acting?
Well, I will. I mean, I have some stuff coming up that I'm working on more completely, like producing and writing and directing.
Mm-hmm.
I've been doing it for so many years, and but to be honest,
mm-hmm.
sitting on set and waiting to be called to go to set and then say your five lines of dialogue and then wait around all day, and it's just mind numbing. It's like I read more books than I do acting when I'm working on a movie or something.
La hora nalga. That calls the la hora nalga.
La hora nalga?
Yeah, the like the butt hour.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Oh, la hora nalga. Yeah, sí. But it's like, when I'm making music, I'm constantly creating. I'm in the studio, I'm writing, I'm producing, I'm recording, I'm touring, I'm playing live. I'm
changing something.
Yeah, there's always something happening.
You can't change anything in the script for acting.
No, you have to do what they tell you to do.
And
you have to play
music,
the character.
You can scratch it from zero if you want.
Exactly. And, you know, you're, other than the traveling when you're performing, you're rehearsing, you're constantly getting to play music, you're in front of audiences, you're in the studio recording, you're constantly working and doing something. But when you're making a movie, you're just sitting around and waiting, and then they're like, okay, Drake, be here at 8 a.m. And then like 1 o'clock rolls around, I'm like, are we gonna do anything today? What is going on? And then finally you go to set and you're like, blah 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 blah, da 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 da, blah blah blah. Okay, cut. All right, now we're gonna turn everything around, so see you in 3 hours. You're like, oh my God, I just wanna go home.
Yes, it's hard.
But so that's why I've wanted to get more, if I do more film and television, is to be the writer, the producer, the director, and the actor, so I'm constantly working. The producers and the directors and everybody, they're working all day. They're getting to create, you know, while the actors sit and wait. So the next stuff that I do, I'll have more of a hand in every aspect of the production.
Why did you say yes to the mascara? Because I was in the mask.
Yeah.
Like 3 seasons ago, and you have to wait a lot. You have to be without mask, all suit with these dark clothes and that kind of things. Why did you say yes to that project?
Because it was just so fun. It seemed like, you know, you get to put on a costume and nobody cares. It's kind of like when you do voiceover, like for cartoons or something, like there's not a camera on your face. You can be weirder and funnier and not worried about what people are thinking. And, you know, it just seemed like, you know, I get to go on stage in a mask and dance around and be foolish and make a fool of myself and not have to worry about anything. And it was a ton of fun. I mean, other than the heat under the costume, everything, it was a lot of fun.
The documentary that we saw, when you talk about your first steps in acting, mm-hmm. and music, we saw another face of Hollywood and music and of your own career.
Mm-hmm.
But you're still here.
Yeah.
A lot of people could quit everything.
Yeah, you see it a lot. I mean, I saw a lot of my peers either quit or couldn't couldn't keep going, and it was too difficult, and you know, it's a really rough, tough life. At the end of the day, I mean, I just love what I do. I love performing. I love what I do. So I, you know, and letting something like what happened to me get the best of me and what let them win, you know, I just can't let that happen. So
yes.
I just continue doing what I love to do, and that's what keeps me going.
Yeah, that was a tough decision.
Yeah.
Keep going.
Yeah, it's really tough.
It doesn't matter what.
Yeah, yeah.
But you said something in the documentary that you don't know what's going on with the next steps that you have to take. Maybe you're gonna be like punished in the industry, but that doesn't happen. You could still working as usual or not?
I you know, you're definitely afraid of kind of a backlash from the inside of the industry because you're exposing so much. But no, for me, it's been a positive experience. It's been really nice. You know, I've had a lot of positive response and feedback and people sharing their stories with me and telling me that they've gotten a lot of they've gained a lot from me sharing my story. So it's been nice, you know.
And one new thing about all these repercussions or consequences was the opinion about your family. A lot of people says a lot of good things about your father.
Yeah,
everybody says. Yeah. But a bunch of people say, "Wow, with the father of the DrakeBell's father, it's the best father that you can have." Do you expect that before that?
No. It was really hard for my dad. I was really scared to ask him to be a part of it, but they kept asking. You know, we'd like to have, you know, his side of the story and hear his take on everything, and it was really hard. But I think it was sort of therapeutic and cathartic for him because, you know, he hadn't ever spoken about it, and you know, rarely talked about it. And but no, I think the response he's gotten is fantastic. You know, people are cheering him on, and he's gotten a lot of great reactions and stuff. So, but yeah, that was tough for my dad to kind of go down that.
And I think a lot of people feel more close from you.
Yeah.
Before that, it's after and before that.
Yeah.
It's like something like relates you with them because. Now they know that you are human and you have a lot of problems like everybody else.
Yep. And that was something that when you go through something like this, you always feel alone and nobody's going to understand you. Nobody is going to have
you
similar.
You feel like you are the only people.
Like you're the only one that's being affected, and you're the only one who's experienced this. But through sharing my story, I've learned, you know, how many people can relate to my story and how I can relate with them. And it's drawn us closer, you know, with my fans and with just people in the streets. And when I'm traveling, you know, people are coming up to me and sharing their stories with me. And it's been really nice to kind of share that relation with.
What's your age?
Right now?
Yeah.
I'm old. 37. 27 forever.
You have a lot of lessons to learn.
Oh yeah, I've learned a lot, and there's a lot to learn.
You never stop learning.
No. Life is school, man. You're in school forever. You're learning every day, and
do you remember any time that you said, I know everything?
Oh yeah.
Don't tell me about life. I know what's happening.
My entire 20s. I knew everything. In my 20s, I knew it all.
Yeah.
Now I don't know anything.
How are you living your life with that new philosophy? New perspective.
Yeah, it is a new perspective. You know, you kind of look back and realize that everything that's happened in your life, you know, doesn't have to destroy you. It doesn't have to define you. There are things that have happened to you. That doesn't mean that's who you are. As a result of these things, you know, there's choices you've made, whether good or bad, or things you go back and regret, maybe want to change. But then as you grow, you realize, well, man, I've learned so much from everything that you kind of stop thinking, oh man, I wish I would have changed that or done that differently, or, you know, you find contentment and happiness in where you are today, and without all of that, you wouldn't be where you are today. So yeah, you kind of have to take all of those as learning lessons and not let it destroy you or define you.
In which context did you write this song?
I was going through a lot of stress and struggle and sadness and despair and, you know, confusion and just looking back at my life and, you know, realizing that, you know, I've a lot of trauma, a lot of sadness, a lot of darkness, and that's kind of where this song came from.
Somebody says that bad decisions, bad situations make good songs.
Yeah.
Is that true?
That's very true. It's very true, unfortunately.
The true challenge to you is this question.
A quesadilla with cheese or no cheese?
Exactly! You know.
Con queso, obvio.
Con queso.
Sí.
¿Las quesadillas llevan queso siempre?
Quesadilla. Quesadilla.
It's always with cheese.
It's in the word. Always with cheese.
Do you have any challenge or any project a long term that you want to achieve?
I mean, I really would love to make this movie. I'd love to be shooting this movie down here in Mexico and producing it and seeing something that I, you know, put on paper up on the screen.
Yeah.
That's a dream. I mean, that would be an absolute dream to be able to go to the premiere of this movie that I had in my brain at one point and then put it on paper and got it made and,
yes,
you know, going to the premiere and...
Everybody knows that if you want to be successful in the Mexican industry, the movie, Mexican industry, you have to be, the people that have to be in the movie, it's Marta Gareda or Aislinn Derbez. Just that.
Okay.
A Mexican movie without one of those actors, it is not a Mexican movie.
Okay. I'll make sure, I'll write them apart.
You have reached a lot of good friendships along this time.
Yeah.
With a lot of Mexican people.
Yeah.
Which is your main circle of you, the people that you would love to go and hang out?
I mean, there's this guy, Alex Montiel. He's pretty cool.
Yeah, yes, he's super cool.
super hip guy. I don't know. I keep my circle pretty small. I mean, I have a lot of acquaintances and stuff, but
yeah.
But my core group of friends that I hang out with are really just a handful of people. It's not many, not really many people.
Do you like to go out to a club or that kind of thing?
Not really. I like more like going with friends out to dinner or seeing a movie,
yes,
or stuff where I can hear myself. You know, I can hear my friends talking to me, not
you are that kind of people now?
Yeah, where I'm like screaming at people trying to...
You can talk anything here.
Yeah, you can.
Can you put a little sound?
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
Drake, it has been great to have this conversation with you.
Yeah.
Remember good times. We know that we are going to watch you for a long time here in Mexico, more and more. Because the movie, because the songs.
Yeah, I hope so.
That's the idea, right?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's the idea.
What about the collaboration? I haven't seen you collaborate in songs with,
yeah,
somebody in this time that a lot of people do collaborations.
Yeah.
Why?
This new album, this new album's so personal, and I was writing from, it's like very vulnerable places, and it's so much about my life that I didn't even think of doing any collaborations. I was just concerned on finishing all of the songs myself and getting my story and everything written the way that I wanted it to, that I ended up finishing everything and never even thinking about approaching anybody for a collaboration or anything like that.
In the idea?
I mean, if I could do a song with Peso Pluma, that'd be awesome.
Yes. Can you give me all your social media for everybody that
I'm just DrakeBell on everything. Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, or X, whatever it is now. and Facebook and all that stuff. Yeah. YouTube, DrakeBell.
Are you interested in make my song for my soccer team?
Yeah, For sure.
You like soccer?
Yeah.
Peluche Caligari. You're gonna sing the next song for my team.
Okay.
Yes?
Yeah.
That's a deal?
Deal. I'm in.
Cool. DrakeBell, thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
And we say goodbye with the scream of war.
Peluche del estuche!